What?
Jen, thank God. I need you to do me a huge favor.
Okay, well, maybe. Depends on how huge.
I need you to do something with Mary this weekend.
No. No, 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 no. That's too huge.
Funny. That's what you said the first time we were about to...
Shut up.
I'm just saying, and you ended up fine.
Just... Why can't you handle your own girlfriend this weekend?
It's just that, Allison called me a couple minutes ago. She said she wants to meet up on Saturday.
Allison? Your ex-girlfriend Allison, the one who claimed she was probed by aliens?
We don't have any evidence that she wasn't.
So, what I'm gathering is you need me to keep your girlfriend occupied this weekend so you can have another one of your adult slumber parties? I don't think so.
Babe, you're jealous. And I thought a little arrangement was working out just fine.
I'm not jealous. I feel sorry for you. And besides, I can't this weekend.
Really, Jen? What could you possibly have going on?
Sabrina and I are going camping this weekend.
You camp? You don't camp. You put on an eyeliner just to walk to the mailbox. And Sabrina...
Don't start with Sabrina. She already hates you. And it's none of your business what we do on the weekend. Regardless, we're too busy to...
But you could take Mary with you, right?
What?
But you could take her with you. Where are you going?
Oh, you know, Goddard.
Goddard? No way, Jen. That's where that guy murdered all those Girl Scouts like 10 years ago.
That's a stupid myth. People go camping there all the time.
Okay, great. So it's settled. You'll take Mary camping.
What? No, no, no. Look, I'm not...
Oh, no, no, no. That's perfect. Thanks, Jen. Oh, you won.
But... How does she know who I am? And why does she give a damn about? I've got 2 tickets to Iron Maiden.
Ever hated him this much. And if I think that spending all weekend with the holy Christian maiden over there is gonna be hell, then I can only imagine how you must be feeling. Please remind me why you refuse to think of Chris as anything other than God's gift to the world.
Sabrina, he's a good guy if you bother getting to know him. You don't give him enough credit.
Something tells me that you wouldn't be saying that if the two of you weren't.
Ahem, do you mind? The sooner we get to the site, the sooner we can set up camp, and the sooner I can go to sleep and pretend that I'm anywhere but here with you two.
You know, you didn't need to come with us. There's such a thing as putting your own happiness above your boyfriend's.
There's also such a thing as sacrificing your own happiness for the happiness of others. And somehow it's important to Chris for me to bond with you two. But I wouldn't expect you to understand. Probably why you haven't had a boyfriend for more than, I don't know, 45 minutes.
Kill yourself, would you?
No. Do you think I'm actually crazy? The whole pretending to have a mental illness thing just happens to work out in my favor. My parents give me what I want, plus free Xanax for my panic attacks. You should try it.
I wish, but there's no way that would work.
Lying is a sin, you know, along with everything else you two participate in. Gluttony, lust, anger.
Fornication. How How's Chris even dating her? There's no way she puts out.
He loves a challenge.
And he's got you to hold him over till he succeeds. Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine. Don't worry about it.
Are you sure? Because you said you missed a couple months of your...
I'm fine. It's probably food poisoning.
Look, if you're Prego, I'm not going to judge you. As long as you're getting rid of it. Right? Like you're going to... Bud?
Okay, fine. You can't tell anyone, though. Especially Chris.
Jen, doesn't he at least deserve to know?
No. Now, promise?
Fine, I promise.
Thanks a lot for the help.
I was kind of hoping you'd break your leg and die.
At least I didn't break my celibacy pledge and condemn myself to an eternity in the flaming depths of hell.
At least we weren't dumb enough to make a celibacy pledge in the first place.
I have you know that premarital
sex is something that most teenagers engage in, including your boyfriend, just not with you.
Excuse me, Satan's mistress. Would you like to take back what you just said about my boyfriend?
I mean, I would, but you did say that lying goes against the Bible.
You filthy mother...
She's kidding, obviously. What the heck?
She would have found out anyway. Chris is too stupid to not get caught.
Campsite's just about half a mile ahead. If we keep going at this rate, we can get there
before. My gosh.
Where is she going now?
Hopefully to go summon the mothership. Get it. She's...
Shut up. Ouch.
You know, that's like the fourth time you've tripped. By the time we get out of here, your little egg might have already omeletted itself.
No, your jokes aren't getting any funnier.
You know, it's not my fault you got pregnant.
Right, sorry, I forgot I was dealing with the abstinence queen over here. Come, your highness.
We're obviously not gonna find her. Can't we just go back? If she gets out, she gets out. It's like survival of the fittest or something.
Look, I'm not gonna just leave Chris's girlfriend here to die.
Why not? You're already gonna kill his firstborn.
Not the time. Mary! Mary!
Ugh.
This is too good.
Oh my god.
What the hell are you doing? Get up.
I can't. I twisted my ankle.
Come on. The campsite's too far away for us to get there tonight, so we might as well-
Jen's pregnant!
Oh, Jen. You poor
thing. Sarah's Virgin Mary. It's your boyfriend's baby. For now, anyway.
Excuse
me? Sabrina!
Jen. It's not true, is it?
No, no, of course it's not. You told?
Then it's true?
What do you want me to say, that I'm sorry? I'm not. This is what happens when you hold out on a guy. He'll just find someone else to give him what he wants. In fact, right now he's...
Get off of me!
No!
Enough!
Let's just set up here. We'll figure everything out in the morning.
So, mind enlightening us as to why you even turned down here in the first place?
I was thinking of something else. My old church group, we went camping this one time and I thought this was the path we went down.
And?
I went camping with my church 3 years ago. I moved to the state 2 years ago.
So? What was so special about some campsite that you went to with your stupid old church group, anyway?
I had my first kiss on that camping trip. There's this kid, and after we kissed, we carved our initials into a tree.
Right. All I'm hearing is that we're stuck here because you're a moron.
This blows.
Is this some sort of joke? You were just bragging at lunch the other day about being an accomplished Girl Scout for the past 12 years.
I never got my campfire badge, okay?
Hey, look, other campers. Let's go.
Should we? Oh, hello. Sit, won't you?
Thanks, but...
Sit. It's rude to refuse hospitality. Have something to eat. You must be famished.
Look, we don't mean to be rude, but we should get going. We probably... Whoa. Ugh.
What's going on? What the hell did you give us?
Whatever do you mean? You're probably just weary. Lie down and have a rest. Constrict your knots. You couldn't get out if you tried.
You're insane!
Why are you doing this? Oh my god. It's true.
What's true?
Chris, when he called me, I told him we were coming out here, and he told me this story about this Girl Scout troop. They were murdered out here. I thought it was a myth. Just a story.
No one ever came across this when we were out there. We were perfectly safe. It's convenient how people make up stories.
How could you have done that? You were just a little kid.
I was a highly advanced child. I knew from a young age that the only joy I could get was from blood and tears. Everyone thirsts for evil. Some of us are just more accepting of it.
You can't do this. You must be a good person. Please.
It's amazing how naive some people remain for their entire lives.
What makes you so much better than me?
I don't...
That's what I thought.
You can change! You can change! I know you can! Please! You're a good person! I know!
On my honor, I will try to serve God and my country, to help people at all times, and to live by the Girl Scout law. I will do my best to be honest and fair, friendly and helpful, considerate and caring, courageous and strong, and responsible for what I say and do. And to respect myself and others, respect authority, use resources wisely, make the world a better place, and be a sister to every Girl Scout.